Hi there. In this video, I'll show you how to build responsive animation using responsive layout. Responsive layout enables you to create different layouts for a single document, letting it function well at any possible screen size. You can see how responsive layout works in this simple example. The navigation bar responds to the browser's width change. It's vertical on large screens, and collapses to a hamburger menu on small screens. The centered text also adapts to the size of the browser window. Now I'm going to show you how to build this example from scratch. First, I'll create a new project. The container size will be 1920 by 1080, as I'll use the desktop-first approach to designing the website, meaning that I'll start from the largest layout and go down to smaller ones. Now, check this box to give the project a responsive layout. And click breakpoints to adjust the breakpoints and layouts. I'll create three new breakpoints at 600 pixels, 900 pixels, and 1200 pixels, and exclude all others. So this is the new responsive project. The scene width and height start at 100%, as you can see in the properties pane. The viewport width is set to the device width, as in the document pane. The breakpoints and layouts are listed in the breakpoints pane. You can modify all these things at any time. So if you forget checking that responsive layout box in the new project dialog, it's okay. For example, if you forget setting a breakpoint, just click the responsive button. And click add breakpoint. Of course, you can adjust and remove any breakpoint as you want. My goal now is to create a simple website that has a side navigation bar when the viewport is wide, and a top navigation bar when the viewport is narrower. I'm going to start by animating in the base layout, where I can set properties and animations to all responsive layouts. After that, I'll open each responsive layout and override properties and animations when needed. This is what I've created in the base layout. The background image covers the entire scene using the fill option. This option scales the image as large as possible without stretching it. The navigation bar contains 5 buttons. Each needs an interactive timeline to hold its states, and works using event actions and JavaScript functions. For details, you can click the link in the video description to see the tutorial and download the project file. In this video, I just focus on how to make this document responsive. On small screens, the navigation bar will collapse to a hamburger menu. So I draw some lines and group them to create two hamburger icons. One for the normal state, and the other for the hover and clicked states. As these icons only appear on small screens, initially I'll hide them using the display property. At this point, you need to take note of one thing. Responsive layout lets you change only properties in animations. It doesn't give you a way to add or remove content. For example, you need the hamburger icons in the smallest layout. But you just cannot add them in this layout only. You can work around this by hiding content until you want them to appear or vice versa. So, I hide the hamburger icons in the base layout where I don't need them. Later on, when I work on the smallest layout, I'll let them appear. Now, let's make this base layout responsive. I want the navigation bar to take up the entire scene height. So I set its height to 100%. By doing so, the height of the navigation bar will be relative to that of the scene. Meaning that when the scene grows and shrinks, the bar's height will adapt. Regarding the page title, I want to center it on the page. So I set its width to 100%. Make it stop position relative. And center the text within the element. But as you can see, the text looks uneven, because the side navigation bar takes up a portion of the scene width. The solution is simple. Just set the text indentation to 110 pixels, which is the same as the width of the navigation bar. The base layout is now perfect. It's time to go to each responsive layout and make necessary changes. And these things will be covered in the next video tutorial. The link is available in the video description.